Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 2.3, Problem 2. This is Section 2.3, Problem number 2. It says perform the scalar multiplications shown below. And there are three separate problems. The first one, you have a matrix with 4, negative 1, positive 1 on the top row, and then 2, 0, 3 on the second row. And there's a 2 in front of that matrix. And what that means is multiply the 2 that's in front of the matrix times every number inside the matrix. So the top row, that 4 in the upper left, becomes 2 times 4, which is 8. The negative 1 in the middle of the top row becomes 2 times negative 1, so it becomes negative 2. And the 1 in the upper right position becomes 2 times 1, which is 2. And then the bottom row, again, every number gets multiplied times 2. So in the bottom left, there's a 2, so it becomes 2 times 2, which is 4. In the bottom middle, there's a 0, so 2 times 0, so it'll actually stay a 0. And then in the bottom right, you have 2 times 3, so that becomes 6. Now the next matrix, you have three rows. There's 1, negative 2, positive 1 in the top, 0, 1, negative 3 in the next row, and in the bottom row, negative 1, 4, 2. And in front of that matrix is a negative 3. So that means multiply negative 3 times every number inside the matrix. So on the top, in the upper left, you have a 1. It becomes negative 3 times 1, which is negative 3. In the top row middle position, you have a negative 2. So that's negative 3 times negative 2, which would be positive 6. And then in the upper right position, you have a positive 1. So it becomes negative 3 times positive 1, which is negative 3. Then coming across the middle row, you have a 0 in the leftmost position. So that would be negative 3 times 0. So that's 0. Then in the centermost position of the matrix is a 1. So negative 3 times 1 is negative 3. And then in the far right position of the middle row, you have a negative 3. So you'd have negative 3 times another negative 3, which would make positive 9. And finally, the bottom row, the bottom leftmost position is a negative 1. So we have to do negative 3 times negative 1 is positive 3. And then the bottom row middle position, you have a positive 4. So you do negative 3 times positive 4, which is negative 12. And then finally, in the bottom right position, you have a 2. So you do negative 3 times positive 2, which is negative 6. And that's the answer for the problem. And now there's one more. You have a matrix with 1, negative 2 in the top position, top row, 1 and then 0 in the middle row, and then 2, 3, both positive in the bottom row, and you have a 4 in front of that matrix. So every item in the matrix has to be multiplied times 4. It's a positive 4 in front. So on the top, you have 1, negative 2. The 1 becomes 4, and the negative 2 becomes negative 8 when each one gets multiplied times 4. The middle row, you have 1 and then 0, so each one gets multiplied times 4. So the 1 becomes a 4. The 0 actually just stays 0. And then in the bottom row, you have 2 and then 3. Each one gets multiplied times 4. The 2 will become an 8. And the 3 will become a 12. And then I'll just put the brackets on that. And then we're done.